Now, this game is interesting. I need to turn this down. So sound options. We're just gonna... That music is really loud. I am surprised. One moment. We are going to do this. We're gonna do this the hard way here. Because that music is very loud. At least to me. Alright. So this title.
That's what she said.
Cranky, you only wish. So this title is interesting in the way that I really enjoyed the first one. And the way it goes is it takes its cues and goes through kind of the evolution of RPGs, or at least the first one did. You started out with like old, you know, Game & Watch kind of graphics where you could only go one way, and then you went up to the... pretty much Game Boy graphics where, you know, you had more dimensional movement and so on and so forth. So I was really interested to see this title and see where they've taken it from here. So I have not tried this at all. I initially loaded it up to kind of get the music volume down a little more, but apparently it wasn't good enough. So here we go. Empty. Let's go with classic, right? Okay. So you can kind of see this is like Game Boy graphics here. Okay. Okay, so I see how they're doing this one. So you can kind of see now this is like a little bit of Link. We don't have, we have direct diagonal movement already. Okay, so they're kind of giving us a little jump on what the last game did, which is perfectly all right. Although for me, I've always found that kind of beeping scrolling text to be slightly annoying and repetitive after a while. Oh, okay. I am really liking the music. Wow. All right. course it could. Because every RPG starts like that, right? Time to activate the machine. Ugh. Why can I hear Cranky already saying that's what she said? Explosion?
No.
Okay. Hey, I gotta give it to them. They've done a really good job. I like this art style already. Music is actually really nice. Yeah, I'm really impressed with this graphic style. Nothing is ever as peaceful as it seems. Oh, right on. We're starting right up in like the Super Nintendo era here. Of course not. No one ever remembers their name. We'll just go with the chosen names. So this is... Alright. Okay, we have no other... Oh, hey. They've done a lot of adding to this. I'm impressed already. Okay, so we gotta go to the forest. Okay, so they've added quite a bit to this for lore. Like, this is well done. Brings me right back to the Super Nintendo era already. I mean, it's nice. The resolution is actually pretty good, like... Okay. Yeah, I figured I needed a weapon. So... Yeah. Okay. So ancient beings outside of time as well. We're hitting all the tropes here. Gotcha. And that means that she'll be in here like the ghost or something at some point, I bet. I'll bet any money on that. Okay. At the bottom, who would be dumb enough to go down the well? Well, I just tried. The village is so boring. You know, everyone always says that, oh, it's so boring, it's so boring, I wish something would happen. And then when shit actually happens, they're like, oh, fuck me. Okay, guys, padding out your game like this is just a bit annoying. Okay, so this is. Oh, I hate puzzles like this. Okay, so it's gonna go for that hook, which is. That goes there. 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 No, it's obviously not going to be this one. It's this one. We did it. All right. Okay, so I was wrong. But knew the house had to be used for something. I really wish we had a run function. That would also be nice. So, great graphics so far. Good music. Now money, yay. Wonder what, no, we can't just run into the hole. Darn. Okay. break your stuff now. Break your pots. Oh. Can I cut down your stuff? Can I be that guy? No. Okay. Can't be that guy. That would have been cool. Had some interaction there, like if you'd gone there and like chopped down his stuff, he'd be like, oh, why'd you do that? It's like, well, because I'm the hero. Apparently the hero of time. Because, yeah, I have no idea what time I'm from. Hi? Sound judder there. One day I'm gonna do this stuff, but not right now. I'm gonna go to sleep. Sounds like some people I know. Okay. So we have. This reminds me of Chrono Trigger quite a bit. That map. So we'll get through this area, see what it's like. And we'll draw a conclusion from there. Or we'll see if we can't upgrade the, or evolve the land, I guess. Because, you know, it's evil land and all. I would like to just also mention that some of the sound stuttering in that may just be that it's not optimized for my system at the moment. This is a review copy, so don't take that as a final product. But the controls are really tight. I'm not finding that I'm fighting the controls to do anything. This is as tight as any Zelda game I've played. Just as well done. I want that. I want that. What did we get? Oh, Red would have a field day with that one. We literally got a gold star. Still no run function, so I assume that the run is something we get later on. Maybe. That's right. There. hero. So we now have a party. So, is this gonna turn into a like random loot battle now? Oh, cool. All right, so that's an interesting way to do it. Do we save? Or did it automatically? Oh, I think it automatically saved. Well, we'll continue going. So that is a really interesting way to have a second person in your party. So your charge skill is your second person, which is awesome. Oh, those things can really throw their nuts. Oh, what was that? That was cool. I like that. So I really enjoy the monster design too. What was that, Cranky? Sorry?
Jealous?
Very much so. Oh! That was not a rock! Okay, apparently no. I need someone else in my party to get past there, I guess. That's alright. Green goo. Okay. Don't want to know. Oh, so there's the ones that we saw earlier, the shadows. Okay. So we'll just get to the next save and we'll call it. Of course we can stop them. We win. Why do people always read things like... Oh, hey. So we got teleported back. Interesting. See? Interesting. So that's how they did it. All right. So this has been very, very interesting. I've been very surprised at how well they've done the second one. I didn't know what they would do to kind of mimic what they did with the first one and how good it was, but this is really interesting. And as you can see, there's a party member now in the right frame there, so... There's got to be collection along the way. This is going to be really interesting. I think this might be a game I end up playing on my own time as well. It's just really well done. I would say if you played the first one and enjoyed it, pick this one up. Or even if you just like old RPGs like this, give it a try. It seems like it's really well done. I'm gonna be playing it a lot more, that's for sure. So, that is my take on that one. And we are going to set up the next title for the chopping block here.